What's going on, YouTube?
Hey, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning into our channel.
I'm Ty.
I'm Katie. We're taking up travel. And today, we're checking out the don'ts of Ireland.
Let's go.
Here we go.
Let's do it.
Right. Sweet.
It's been a long time since we've done an Ireland video.
It has a really long time.
5 months.
Yeah, the last one we did was Geography Now.
Yeah.
We reacted to Ireland.
It's been way too long.
Yeah, today we are checking out a video from Walter's World.
Yes, thank you for the video.
Yes, love this guy.
Yes.
Very knowledgeable, travels all over the world. And today we're checking out Ireland, the don'ts of visiting Ireland.
All right, let's get into it.
Sweet.
Let's do it.
Hey there, fellow travelers. Mark here with Walter's World, and today we're in Dublin, Ireland. We've got St. Patrick's Cathedral behind Dublin. Us, and today what we have for you are the don'ts of visiting Ireland. And even though I'm here in Dublin for this video, the first don't I have for you is don't think Ireland equals Dublin. Look, Ireland is an entire country and it is gorgeous, from the Cliffs of Moher in Galway in the west. You go down to the south, you see Kinsale and Waterford. There is so much beauty in this country, and a lot of people only see
so
Dublin.
Green.
Now, don't get me wrong, Dublin is a cool city, but there's so much more to see when you come here, going down to kiss the Blarney Stone and things like that are quintessential parts of visiting Ireland for a tourist or for locals as well. It's a fun thing to do, but do not think that Dublin equals Ireland. And that's what I'm going to say. Another don't for you is don't get freaked out with the prices in Dublin, because the prices outside of Dublin are a lot more affordable, okay? So that's where I'm gonna leave off with our Dublin
that
stuff,
makes sense.
All right?
Big city.
Now, my second don't for you is don't think that it rains all the time. I mean, look, I'm glistening. That's not rain, that's sweat, because it's sunny and warm and nice here. Yes, it is sunny in Ireland sometimes. So don't think when you're gonna come here, oh, my vacation's gonna get ruined because it's gonna rain all the time. That is not the case. Now, I won't say it doesn't rain.
Yeah,
it does rain
that?
A lot here.
I don't
here,
know. Go
all
back.
Right?
That was like a huge statue on that roof.
Yeah, what was that?
It's going to rain all the time. That is not the case. Now, I won't say it doesn't rain.
That's
it
so
does
weird.
Rain
driving
a
on the
lot
left side.
Here. All right?
Oh,
but just know that it's not always raining in Ireland, so relax on that. But with the weather stuff, I do recommend wearing layers. I mean, I got two t-shirts and a sweatshirt on, because I know now I'm sweating a little bit, so I might take this off. But I know in an hour or two, it might cool down,
wow,
and yes, it might rain.
Yeah.
And so I guess another don't with the weather is when they do say it's going to be a sunny day, don't think that means it isn't going to rain, all right? So always either have a jumper with you or a jacket or an umbrella, because it probably will rain. It doesn't rain all the time, but it might rain occasionally, okay? My next don't for you is don't think you're going to get out of Ireland without meeting some Irish people. Look, the people in Ireland are super friendly, and they will come and talk to you. Even if you want to have some time alone, enjoying music and having a pint, they're going to say hi. They're going to come talk to you. They're
going
to give you tips and advice of where to go,
just
where to eat,
people.
What sights to see, where to stay, all these things, because the people here are fantastic. And that's one of the great things about Ireland, are the Irish people. From their sense of humor and their wit to them making a little bit of fun of you. You know, I can't tell how many times I've had, oh, I see you enjoyed our Irish stew quite a bit. I'm like, yes. Yes, I did, okay? And I guess that'll lead us into the next don't we have for you is don't think Irish food is bad, or don't be surprised if you actually like the food here. Look, the last 10 years have seen a revolution in Ireland in terms of the food culture. The food is fantastic. There's great restaurants, eating at the pubs,
fries with
all
eggs?
Kinds of stuff is a fantastic thing
good.
To do and enjoy. I mean, think about this. 10, 20 years ago when you came to Ireland, it wasn't a culinary delight. Now it is. So go and have the seafood chowder when you're by the sea, or have the lamb.
Ooh.
Or have some of the pies
fish?
That are here,
fish
you know, shepherd's
chips,
pie
or
fish pies. Oh my goodness, the food's so good. Sausages, a full Irish breakfast. Oh my goodness, you will eat very well here. So don't think it's not going to be a culinary treat here. Now, my next don't for you is don't forget that they drive on the left and you have to look to the right.
Oh, yeah.
Look, here in Ireland, they drive on the left, so it's the opposite side of like Germany or the US. And for tourists, you really need to rent a car when you're here to really go and explore the beautiful sites and castle ruins and Neolithic ruins and things like that. Because public transport does go a lot of places, but not all the time. So if you really want to see Ireland, you've got to rent a car. But don't forget, you got to drive on the left. Also, don't forget, when you're crossing the street, look right so you don't get smashed by the cars, okay? Because I have seen a few tourists do the woo-hoo-hoo jump back because they thought they were going to get smashed, okay? Another don't I'll have for you with the driving is don't think you're going to get an automatic car when you rent a car here. Most of the rental cars here are manual. If you want automatic, you are going to pay a huge upcharge for that. So just a heads up for that one, okay? And also, I guess I'd say my last don't for the driving is don't freak out while you drive, okay? Because the roads can get pretty tiny and that can be a little scary when you got this hedgerow on the side semi coming on the right side of you and you're like, I'm not used to this. It's okay to slow down when you do drive here, okay? I was wrong, I did have another don't for you, is don't get into an accident when you want to pull off to the side of the road to look at some of the sights, because you'll be going on these windy roads and see a castle ruin here or a stately home or just beautiful vistas. So don't just pull off the road right away, because I've seen people almost have accidents that way.
Oh, wow.
So a lot of times when there's a beautiful view or something like that, there might be a pull-off you can go into. So do the pull-offs to take your pictures. Don't park in the road or park on the side, because since the lanes are so small, that can be pretty dangerous. And I have seen a lot of tourists doing that, so I thought it'd be a good idea to mention.
Wow, look at those buses.
And when you go to those medieval castles, you know, if you're going to go to the Rock of Cashel or Blarney Castle or something like that, another don't I have for you is don't mess around on the steps. Look, the medieval staircases, these circular staircases, they're small, steep steps.
Yeah, they're
so
narrow.
So claustrophobia might be a thing, but also slipping and falling. So don't mess around when you're on those, because I have seen some people fall down a few steps and get hurt kind of bad, so I don't want that to happen to anybody. So do pay attention. And if you're going to be going with your kids to these sites, realize if you're going to go to the Blarney Stone or something like that, or you're going to go to Kilkenny and you want to go up the Round Tower, sometimes there are height restrictions for people that can go in to see these things, because you don't want the kid actually slip and fall off the top of Blarney Castle, okay? Another don't, I'm going to follow on with that since I'm talking about kids, is don't think you can have your kids in the pub after 9 o'clock. Now, sometimes you can get away with it, but most pubs will say, you know, they'll be really kind of, look, it's 9 o'clock, the kids have to go. And the thing is, you might want to stay longer because there's live music and food and drinking and stuff like that. And some places are very strict with the 9 p.m. kids have to be out of the pub kind of rules. And pubs can make their own rules for that. So if you want to go and eat dinner at a pub or something like that with your family, make sure you're doing it earlier in the day instead of later at night. And so that might mean the kids might miss some of the music, because I've seen a lot of the bars and pubs, or the pubs I should say, when they have their live music, it starts about 10 o'clock at night. Some start at 7:30 or 8, but most have them at 10. So just have a heads up for that, okay? Now, another don't I have for you is don't skip out on the local brews. Yes, this is the home of Guinness and the home of Smithwick's and Murphy's, and there's so many great beers you can have here, and of course whiskeys, and so you should try them. And I will say, with the beers like Guinness and Smithwick's and Murphy's, drinking it here in Ireland, it's like you're drinking a completely different beer, because it's so fresh, it's so good, it's so tasty. You really will fall in love with Irish beers and stouts and reds and ales, because they are really good here. Because the thing is when beer, you know, if it goes to the U.S., it takes time, all these kind of things, so you're not getting it as fresh. Whereas here, it's like, because it's like it's coming from the beer keg, you know, just right from the tap. Oh, it's like, I mean, it's just amazing when you come here. So don't skip out on the local ales. But I will say is, don't forget your limit when you're drinking here. Look, those Guinnesses and Stouts and Reds, they're pretty strong beers, and they taste pretty good. So if you're knocking them back, it's very quick. You'll see a lot of tourists don't know their limit, and they have a bit too much. And you'll see that a lot here in Dublin at the Temple Bar area. Man, don't go there late night if you're not ready for some really drunk people, okay? But do be smart with your drinking when you are here. Don't forget your limit. And of course, don't drive drunk when you are here. It's a zero tolerance policy. You will get arrested. They do not care if you're a tourist or things like that. And if you think about it, you're driving on the other side of the road after you've been drinking. Just not a good idea.
Yeah.
Now, going back to the pub, I will say something is, if you do buy pints at the pub and stuff like that, you do not have to tip here in Ireland at the pub. So that's kind of a nice thing. You just go and you pay for your beer and walk away. You can leave some coins if you want, but you don't have to. And if you're paying a bar bill with a credit card, there's nowhere to write a tip anyway. So don't worry about the tippings at the pub. I mean, you can give some, but don't feel like you have to, all right?
Oh,
now,
wow.
Not having a tip at the pub and a really good beer, and your kids can't go there at night, some people may think, oh, well, I'll just have a drink here in the park. Well, another don't I have for you in here in Ireland is don't drink in public. Look, if you drink in public, you can be fined here, so heads up with that one. So if you want to buy your own drinks, make sure you have a place to drink it inside, not in a park or an outdoor space, because otherwise, you can get a pretty hefty fine. Now, heading back to kind of the people kind of thing when you are here, don't forget to remember your manners here in Ireland. You will hear please and thank you and sorry, 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 sorry so many times here in Ireland because the people are pretty polite when you talk to them. And so don't forget your P's and Q's. You know, when you're driving by, you pass people, you wave and stuff like that. But do make sure you remember your manners, which is funny because my next don't for you is don't come here with sensitive ears. Look, the Irish love to cuss, and it doesn't matter if you're a little kid or an old grandma, you will hear cuss words you might not have heard before, or you have heard before but never used in so many times in one sentence. That does happen here a lot, so don't be prudish about it. Just realize that it seems like a lot of the Irish do have a sailor's mouth, and you will be surprised how much you do hear cussing when you are here. So don't be upset by it. So my next don't for you is don't try to see all of Ireland in one go. Yes, it's kind of a small island. When you look at it, oh, I could see all of that. Look, there's too many things to see in Ireland to go and do it all, because then you end up spending very little time and you're just driving from spot to spot to spot. Take the time, spend a few nights in each location to really go and see a lot of things. Because if you just spend one night somewhere, you're only going to see one thing and go. So what I recommend is go and pick like a region, okay? On this trip, we did kind of more of the mid-south.
So
we did,
we came to
Dublin, then went to Kilkenny, and then we went down to Cork and Kinsale and Blarney, and then went to Waterford, and we kind of did this triangle like that. Maybe you want to do the west. I mean, for me, the west of Ireland is the most beautiful part, going to Galway and the Barrens and the Cliffs of Moher and things like that.
Yeah.
And what you really should do is, I'm honest, is pick a region and really focus on that, because there's tons of castle ruins and medieval ruins and stuff like that, and Neolithic ruins. I mean, there's stuff here that's older than the pyramids here in Ireland that you can go see that man-made. I mean, it's really, really cool. You know, and you can see those things. So do go and
really
don't try
cool.
to do it all. Select different areas and come back, because my next don't for you is don't pay too much to get here. That's one of the best things about coming to Ireland is it's really cheap. Whether you're flying from mainland Europe or the US, getting to Ireland is significantly cheaper year-round than anywhere else in Europe. I mean, we're here and it was literally, I mean, it was half the price of flying to Paris. And so look for those deals to come here, because then you can use that money to go a lot farther, and that's really kind of cool. Another thing that some people sometimes get worried about is they're like, what about the safety in Ireland? Am I going to be safe there? Yes, you'll be safe in Ireland. The troubles and things like that, that's not really an issue really going on anymore, okay? So you don't have to worry about the 1970s and 60s and 80s kind of stuff. That doesn't go on. The biggest worry you're going to have is when you're driving on the left side of the road, you're going to hit somebody or lose the mirror on the side of your rental car. I do suggest getting the full super collision insurance thing, by the way. All right, so it is pretty safe here. The only things I've really felt kind of uncomfortable about was too many people drinking in Temple Bar, which is normal because it's a bar area, okay? So other than that, don't worry, you'll be okay when you come here. But of course, do pay attention, do watch out for things, because you know you're going to be a tourist anyway, and no place is perfect, but hey, it's not too bad here. Now, another don't I have for you is don't call the Irish English or British. That is the one thing that I've seen will upset an Irishman, because like, hey, we separated from them. We are not part of that. We are Ireland. We are the Republic of Ireland. So do not call them that.
That makes sense.
I will say another thing that kind of goes along with that is remember, don't forget your euros and pounds if you're going to be coming here and visiting the entire island. Because Northern Ireland, they use pounds. So if you're going to go to Belfast or go see the Giant's Causeway, which is one of the coolest you know, natural sights I've ever seen in the world, you're going to need your pounds up there. But then the rest of Ireland, the Republic, you use the euro when you are here. And what's cool is there's plenty of ATMs. So you can get cash out, no big deal. And my last don't for you here in Ireland is don't skip a chance to see a Gaelic sports match. And the thing is, it could be hurling, which is like kind of like hockey, and it's like field hockey and normal hockey and UFC mixed together, where they have this ball and they're batting it up and whacking it and things like that. I mean, it's this crazy sport to watch. But for me, the coolest one was watching Gaelic football or Irish football. It's basically take basketball, soccer, rugby, and UFC, mix it together, and that is what Gaelic football is. We got to watch the All-Ireland final, and it was like, oh my, dude, this sport is so awesome. And the thing is, the people have so much pride in their country and their sports.
You have the Gaelic
Athletic Association and all these kind of things, and you have some of the best tour guides in the world here in Ireland, because the people, it's not just a job, it's a passion for their country and their culture, and that's why it makes so fantastic. So I hope this video helps you get prepared and excited to come to Ireland. It's a fantastic country with fantastic people and sights, and please do go, because it is well worth it. Anyway, yeah. If you want to learn more about visiting Ireland,
that sounds awesome.
Yeah, it does.
I did that last time.
Oh,
I
no.
clicked on a different video at the end. I went to go pause it. Yeah, that looks like a great place to
travelers.
Go visit.
Hey, Mark here with Walter's World today.
Oh, Chicago. We've been there.
Yes, we have.
Sweet. That was a great video.
Yeah, those pubs looked fun.
Yeah. Yeah, really. Oh my gosh, that whole street looked awesome. The food looked great. Oh,
yeah.
I'd love to go to Ireland.
Yeah, me too. I'm surprised really that he said that it's the cheapest to go to.
Yeah.
He said like half the price to what it took him to go to Paris.
Right.
It's like, dang,
it's
really?
Like, go to Ireland, check out Ireland.
Yeah.
And then you can go to other countries too if you want.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
That'd be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Gotta go.
Oh my gosh, we have to do that one day.
Definitely.
That'd be so sweet. Ah, well, let us know in the comments down below if you've been to Ireland, or maybe you're watching from Ireland right now. If you've enjoyed this video, definitely let us know. Hit the like button. And what should we watch next?
Yeah, let us know. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if it's your first time coming across our channel and checking out one of our videos, please give us a quick subscribe.
Hit that notification bell to stay up to date, because we come out with videos every single day.
And
we can't wait to see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
See ya.